Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Avery, and today I have some romance recommendations for y'all. This upcoming weekend, April 3rd through the 5th, a bunch of other BookTube ladies and I are hosting a readathon called the Romance Takeover Buddy Read Readathon. I know it's kind of a mouthful, but we have like four categories for this readathon. All the readathon information is in the video that I have linked down below with my announcement and everything. It has four categories: science fiction, paranormal, contemporary, and historical. So I thought that I would give y'all recommendations for each of those genres. I tried to pick more of the underrated ones that aren't as popular as some others in the romance community, so that's the way that I went about this. So I've maybe around 3 to 4 for each genre. I think paranormal has the most because I have so many recommendations for paranormal, but we'll start with science fiction. I have 3 recommendations for those. So I've read a lot of alien romance books, but most of them are all from the same author or the same series or spin-off series, and that's Ruby Dixon's Ice Planet Barbarians. I know I just said that I would be recommending books that aren't as popular or as talked about as some others, but I can only talk about this series and a couple of others because I haven't read a bunch of other series. I've read this whole entire series, which is over 20 books, so I've read a lot of alien books from Ruby Dixon. This series, everyone almost knows about it in the romance community. Basically, human women get captured by evil aliens, but the ship that the aliens have stored them in have crash-landed on this ice planet, and these women are the only survivors from the crash. And the only inhabitants on this ice planet are blue Sukui aliens. And the human women find mates with the aliens. And each book is about a different couple. It sounds weird, but it's honestly really addicting and I really, really love it. There's also the spin-off series, which is the Ice Home series. I have the first book in that series, which is Lauren's Barbarian. I think this was the first Ruby Dixon book that I ever read, but I don't recommend going my route. I was kind of confused as to what was going on when I read this one first, just because a bunch of the world building and the terms happen in the other original series at the beginning. So I really recommend starting with the original series, but this series is good nonetheless. If you have already read the Ice Planet Barbarian series and are looking for a series very similar, I have Dragon's Baby in the first book in this Red Planet of Tejas series by Miranda Martin and Juno Wells. This series is very, 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 very similar to the Ice Planet Barbarian series. I think I've read maybe 4 or 5 books from this series. I have not read all of them, but I do remember when I read this book, I was kind of really upset because it was so similar to Ice Planet Barbarians that I got really upset. Basically, it's Ice Planet Barbarians, but instead of them being on an ice planet, they're on a desert planet. And the aliens are like part dragon. Draconi. So I'm not upset anymore about it. I don't really care. These books are a fun thing to listen to. I think they're on Audible Escape, if I'm not mistaken. That's how I listen to them. And also Ice Planet Barbarians is on Kindle Unlimited, and some of them are on Audible Escape as well. So if you want something similar to this series, it's not my favorite thing, but it's very similar to Ice Planet Barbarians. And the last science fiction romance book that I have to recommend to you is Assigned a Mate by Grace Goodwin. This one is also on Audible Escape, as well as I believe the first 3 books in this series. These are way more steamy. I think this is probably the steamiest book on this entire list, I wanna say. This series is basically a mail order bride series, but interstellar mail order bride. So there's this bride program on Earth now where convicted felons who are women, they can choose either to stay in prison for the rest of their life or get sent to another planet and be married to an alien. The first book is about this woman who is actually in the witness protection program, and the government is trying to keep her safe from this guy. And I believe she gets sent to a prince, and it's these aliens are really into BDSM, y'all. If you really want a steamy short audiobook, this one's the way to go. Next we have historical. Now I actually haven't read all that many historical romance books. I'm actually currently reading a historical romance book, and hopefully that will become a new favorite. But since I haven't read all that many, I think I'm just gonna recommend the ones to y'all that I know for sure are good. So some of these are more popular than most, but these are the only ones that I can recommend, honestly. First, we have one of my more recent reads. We have A Notorious Vow by Joanna Shoup. This book was in my video for romances with disability representation in it, because our male main character is deaf, and then our woman main character has severe social anxiety, and they're kind of put into a marriage of convenience, and I loved this. It's an amazing audiobook. It's an amazing book. Kind of a gruff man who is a outcast, but also made himself an outcast, and his kind of marriage of convenience with this woman who hates crowds and just wants to be by herself. I really recommend this one. I really connected to our main character because I have social anxiety, so I really recommend this one. Next, we have an LGBTQ+ historical romance. We have It Takes Two to Temple by Kat Sebastian. I believe this one is on Kindle Unlimited. The best way that I can describe this book is, I've been saying it from the beginning, it is a gay version of The Sound of Music, but without the music. Basically, it's about this vicar who kind of becomes the tutor to these children who are really rambunctious in the town, and he starts developing feelings for their father, who is a Navy captain whose wife died a couple years ago. It reminds me a lot of The Sound of Music, y'all. And the last historical romance for y'all that I have to talk about is the Girl Meets Duke series by Tessa Dare. This one is probably the most popular out of the bunch for historicals. The first one is Duchess Deal, the second one is The Governess Game, and the third one is The Wallflower Wager. These are all great romance books. Really, really funny. Amazing chemistry between the characters. I really recommend them. This one is about a man who was hurt in war, wounded in war. When he comes back from war, his future wife sees his face and calls off their engagement, can't be with him anymore. And so her wedding dress that she has ordered gets canceled, and this woman, the seamstress who has worked so long in this wedding dress, gets really upset because she's not gonna get paid anymore for this dress that she worked so hard on. So she goes to his house and basically demands that she pay him. They kind of get married out of convenience because he needs an heir, and I don't remember the reason why she wanted to marry him. But this one's a really great kind of like dislike to love relationship. Now, this one is a historical romance between a governess and the guardian to two little girls that she's watching over. I loved this. I really loved the two children in this book. I loved them a lot. They were really, really, really funny. And the last one in this series, probably my favorite one, is The Wallflower Wager by Tessa Dare. This is about a main character named Penny, who kind of collects pets that nobody wants anymore or who need medical attention. And so her house has become filled with animals, and next door is Gabe, who just bought the house next door to her to remodel it and sell for a higher profit. But then he realizes with all the animals next door, no one's gonna want to buy this house. And so Penny and Gabe have to go on kind of like a quest or mission to find homes for all of these animals, because she needs to find homes for them for a different reason. When you will read the book, you will find out. A great dislike to love again. We're gonna stop the video for a second to shout out someone from my shout out mug. Every video I try to shout someone out. So let's do this. We'll do this one. This one is, oh, it's Kayla from Literature Reads. I absolutely love Kayla a lot. She became one of my first like romance booktube friends. I've gotten so many recommendations from her. She is so cute, so amazing. She's really into BTS, so if you like BTS, please go follow Kayla as well. I'm personally not into BTS, but I love her passion for it. She also works in a bookstore, and she films a lot of reading vlogs that I love. Her reading vlogs are probably my favorite thing. She just is a great romance booktuber that I highly, highly, highly recommend, so please go check Kayla out. Next, I'm going to be talking about contemporary romance. Now, I read a lot of contemporary romance, so these are three that I feel like deserve way more hype. First, we have the Forbidden Hearts series by Alicia Rai. Alicia Rai just came out with The Right Swipe, if you've read that book. It has a beautiful, fun, illustrated pink cover. But these books are actually by her too. And a lot of people don't actually know that this series was written before The Right Swipe. And The Right Swipe is actually a spinoff to this series. You meet the main character, a woman who's in The Right Swipe, in these books. These books are amazing. They have a great cast of diverse characters. Japanese descent, Hawaiian descent, mixed race. We have plus size representation. We have bisexual representation. And the audiobooks are fantastic, by the way. First one is Hate to Want You. Second chance romance, kind of Romeo and Juliet-esque. And then we have Japanese, Hawaiian, I believe, mixed race in here, which is really great. That's, I believe, the main character woman's race, because I've never read a book that has a representation in it before. And then the second book, I believe she is Indian American and he is of Japanese and Hawaiian descent. And she is bisexual. She's a widow and her late husband's brother is right there. And then this one is probably my favorite in the series. He is of Hawaiian descent, I believe, and she is plus size. I believe there's also an age gap in this one, if I'm not mistaken. Just a great series overall, highly recommend. Next, you have Rafe, A Buff Male Nanny by Rebecca Weatherspoon. I listened to this audiobook and I loved it. A very, very, very refreshing read. This is about Rafe, who is a male nanny, and he becomes the male nanny to these two black little girls, and his love interest is their mom, who is black. So I had a really, really, really fun time reading this book because obviously I'm not of African American descent. I do not know some of the things that go on in their culture, and like I had no idea that like they had to do special things with their hair and just a bunch of other things. And I read about it in this book, and even like Rafe, who's like buff and like basically a ginger and has a giant beard and big muscles, has to basically like help these girls take care of like their hair and put braids in their hair. And it was really cute to read about, and it's his relationship with their mom. And I found it really refreshing in the sense that it wasn't about these two characters hiding their feelings the whole time, like, oh my gosh, I have a crush on my employee, oh my gosh, I have a crush on my boss. It wasn't that kind of thing. They almost immediately told each other, hey, I have feelings for you, what are we gonna do about it? And I found that so refreshing. So if you want a fun, interesting, different read, this one's the way to go. And the last one on this list for contemporary, we have Heidi's Guide to Four-Letter Words by Tara Civic and Andy Arndt. This one is an audiobook I believe I listened to in a day. It is so good. I believe it's only on Audible. It's an Audible original and it's on Audible Escape. I love this book. Probably the most I've ever laughed in a book in my entire life. So basically this is about Heidi, and she is in need of a job. She ends up accidentally getting a job at a audiobook company or studio where they read dirty books. So to help her become more comfortable with her work environment, she decided to start up a podcast where she reads dirty books to help her become more comfortable. And throughout all of this, she has a huge crush on her neighbor, and she's hoping that her becoming more comfortable talking about books like these will help her get enough courage to go up and ask him out. I loved this so much. Most I've ever, ever, ever laughed while reading a book. It is so stinking good. And lastly, we have Paranormal Romance. I believe I have 5 recommendations for y'all. First is the book that I only have physically from this section. We have The Winter King by C.L. Wilson. Now this one's a little bit of a thicker book. If you wanna read, try to read maybe one book out of this readathon. I feel like it flies by. This one is a fantasy romance. So this is about our princess, Kasmin, and her relationship with the Winter King. And the Winter King is known for being very brutal and kind of evil. Kamzin is kind of locked away in her palace because her father actually hates her. The king hates her. And so the Winter King, who's the king of a neighboring country, comes to their land and tells this king, hey, I'm not gonna attack you if you let me marry one of your very famous daughters. Kamzin is not one of them because no one knows about her because she's been hidden away for so long. And so Kamzin's dad wants to really defy the king and kind of get Kamzin out of his house. Instead of Kamzin's dad marrying the Winter King to one of his famous daughters, he secretly marries him to Kamzin because she's like wearing a veil and he can't see her face. It's kind of like a dislike to love because the Winter King is a very big, grouchy man. He has winter powers and she ends up having storm powers. I remember really enjoying this. It was a really fun read for me. Next, you have another Ruby Dixon book. We have Fire in His Blood. This one is a series, just like Ice Planet Barbarian, if you wanna read a series out of this. I believe these are on Audible Escape and Kindle Unlimited, if I'm not mistaken. But basically, this is a post-apocalyptic book dealing with dragons. One day, a portal opens up in the sky and dragons start flying out and decimating the entire planet to where there are only a few small camps of survivors in this post-apocalyptic setting. It's about this woman who basically gets sacrificed by her camp to these dragons in hopes that the dragon will leave them alone, and no one knows that these dragons can actually shift into people. And so it's about her and her romance with a dragon shifter. Each book is about a different couple. I haven't read the whole series yet, but I found these really fun to read. Next, we have a wolf shifter. We have Moonlight by Lisa Kessler. Now, it's been a while since I've read this series. I believe the series is 9 books long, and I've completed them. I was obsessed with them. They're not, like, the best written things, but I was obsessed with them. I was obsessed with them. I wanted to know what was going to happen, and each book is about a different couple. So in this series, wolf shifters are sworn enemies to panther shifters, and it's about this romance between a wolf shifter and a panther shifter, but she has no idea that she's a panther shifter, and he like helps her through that, and they like become mates and everything, and I really enjoyed this and I enjoyed the rest of the series as well. Next we have Master of Crows by Grace Draven. Now I've recommended Radiance by Grace Draven constantly on this channel. I feel like I need to give some love to Master of Crows. This one is so stinking good. This book has always given me Feyre and Rhys vibes. So basically, it's a romance between this brooding wizard, and I believe this woman becomes his apprentice. It's a romance between the two. Like, it has the same, like, gruff vibes that Rhys gave off to Feyre in the beginning of ACOTAR. It just deals with magic and a magical world, a magical setting. I feel like if you like ACOTAR, you might like this book. And lastly in this video, we have Transcendence by Shay Savage. Now this is a time travel caveman book. Our main character, a woman, her dad, he works at like a history museum, but he's secretly been making a time machine. And so she accidentally, when she's going to visit him, touches the time machine and gets sucked back in time to when only cavemen existed. And it's her romance with a caveman named Ed. I'm a big sucker for books where they don't have the same language. That's what was in this book. If you have recommendations for this, please let me know. It was in Ice Planet Barbarians and in this one where they have a really hard time communicating and they can't communicate because they don't speak the same language. I love that in romance books. So please give me recommendations down below if you have any. But this is a prime representation of that, and it is so cute. I loved it. But anyways, there you have it. Those are some recommendations for this upcoming readathon. Most of these are pretty short, so you can get them done within the weekend, but I can't wait to watch all of my other hosts' recommendations videos. Go check out their other videos as well to see what they posted and recommended. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching, and I will see y'all soon this weekend with my reading vlog. Bye.